Hello and welcome to Total Health with Dr. Nick, where if you're new to my channel, my purpose is to inspire, empower, and motivate you to live longer, healthier, and more abundant lives. And today I've got a great video. In fact, this is one I've been wanting to do for a long, long time, and that is, what is the difference between ketosis and ketoacidosis? I get this question all the time because many of you are out there fearful. You know, Dr. Nick, I've heard how great the keto diet is, but I'm afraid to start it because I don't want to get ketoacidosis. I've heard it's very dangerous. It could be life-threatening, or you've got maybe type 1 or type 2 diabetes, and you're thinking, well, I've heard I can't do this because if I have type 1 or type 2 diabetes, I might get ketoacidosis. Well, guys, I'm here to hopefully comfort you, dispel some of the myths, and tell you exactly what ketoacidosis is all about and really what the difference is than just healthy and beneficial ketosis. So, once, before we get started, if you like what we're talking about, please make sure you like, you share, you comment, and subscribe. Make sure you click that little bell notification so that you're notified anytime I do a video. And if, guys, if you're looking to do the keto diet in the best way possible to where you get the best results, get in the best shape of your life, check out my keto course. It's called Ultimate Keto with Dr. Nick. The link is down below. I will tell you in all honesty, it is the best course by far for ketogenic diet on the internet. We put a lot of hours into this course. It's got everything from meal planning to diets to recipes. It's got shopping lists. It's got inspiration, motivational videos. It's got movies in it. It literally has everything you need to be successful on your ketogenic diet so that you're doing it right and you're getting the best results possible. So once again, click the link below. See if it's a fit for you. If not, then you can just continue watching my channel. There's lots of great information on here too. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started with, what is the difference between ketosis and ketoacidosis? What is ketosis first? Now, ketosis, let me dispel one myth, and this is really coming from a video that I had done, I'd say probably about a year ago, where I was talking about some comments that Jillian Michaels had made, where she said, ketosis is an emergency state. This is not normal for the body. But reality, Jillian, is it's very normal for the body. This is what our ancestors went through when they were either hunting and foraging, had feast and famine. Sometimes they ate lots and lots of food. Sometimes they ate nothing. Think of it this way. Your body is like a hybrid car. When you first start up a hybrid car, you're in electric mode, and you're typically going across the parking lot, and basically sounds like you're in a golf cart. It doesn't make much noise. It doesn't make a sound. It just has that little bit of a hum. When you get on a highway and you're doing some more mileage, it just switches over to gas. So it's very simple. One form of fuel to another. Your body's the exact same way. When it wants quick fuel, it typically burns glucose for fuel. When it wants long sustained burning fuel, you typically will burn ketones. And ketones happen to be a better fuel source. So ketosis just simply means when your body runs out of glucose, it's going to start burning something else. When the stored glucose that's kept in your liver and your muscles is gone, your body flips that switch and it starts to burn fat for fuel. And that's really what we want to do. So now let's talk about ketoacidosis. Now, where does that come from? Well, it's typically also called diabetic ketoacidosis. And this is a very dangerous condition to be in. And it typically happens in type 1 and type 2 diabetics, although it's very rare in type 2 diabetics. But it also can happen in patients who have illness or infection. So, diabetic ketoacidosis, or DKA, happens when your blood sugar is very high and ketones build up to dangerous levels in your body. So there's a couple of key things happening here. So let's kind of give you a diagram of what's really going on with this. So if you think of this like your blood, and here's one of your human cells, some key things are happening here. Number one is that you have to have high blood sugar, very high blood sugar. Number two, if you're typically type 1 or type 2 diabetic, you either have very low to no insulin. So what does that mean now? Insulin is a hormone that stores things. So what it does is it takes your blood sugar, it shuttles it into your cells so your cells can use it for fuel. Well, if you have high blood sugar and no insulin or very low insulin, you're not going to get that blood sugar into the cell to be burned. So the cell's going to say, hey, I've got no fuel here. What am I going to burn? Oh, wait, let's start using ketones. So let's start to produce ketones. So what happens is, when you can't get the sugar into your cell, ketones start to rise in the body. So this is what the difference is. Ketosis is a normal state the body's in when the ketones tend to be low. Ketoacidosis is a very, very acidic state when you have high, high, high amounts of sugar, very low amounts of insulin, and very, very high, much higher than in ketosis, amounts of ketones. So what does this look like when we're talking about the classic bell curve as to where you want to be when you're in ketosis in the normal state, or when you're in ketoacidosis in an abnormal and dangerous state? So what it looks like is this: anywhere from 0.5 to about 3, that's your what we call nutritional ketosis. That's where you're in therapeutic ketosis. So 0.5 to about 3 millimolars. Now, when you start to get above 3, so now you're looking at 5, 6, 7, 10, when you get into that range and your ketones are that high, that's when you are in dangerous, dangerous levels. When you're checking, and we talk about this all the time, that's why we recommend the ketone monitor called Keto Mojo. When you're checking your ketones on a regular basis, you don't have to worry about this. So guys, don't worry about getting into ketoacidosis when you're on the ketogenic diet, because it really is much more beneficial and it prevents ketoacidosis from happening, because you're keeping your sugars down. You're keeping your carbs down, where in ketoacidosis, your sugars are very high. So that's a very, very distinctive feature. Very high sugars in ketoacidosis, very low sugars in the ketogenic diet. Now, let's look at the key distinctions here. Number one, between ketosis and ketoacidosis, let's look at ketones, glucose, and electrolytes. What kind of levels are we looking at here? Well, in the ketogenic diet, you have low levels of ketones. In ketoacidosis, you have high levels of ketones, very, very high. What about glucose? Well, in glucose, in the ketogenic diet, we want to keep the glucose down. We want to keep the carbs down, right? It's about 5% of your calories for the day. So very low levels of blood sugar, glucose. In a ketoacidosis state, you have very, very high levels of blood sugar. What about your electrolytes? Well, in ketosis, they're typically normal, especially if you're drinking some of the recommended drinks we talk about. You're keeping your electrolytes normal. So your sodium, potassium pump, your phosphorus is all good. Everything is working the way it's supposed to. Your cells are getting proper nutrients. In a state where you're looking at ketoacidosis, you have very low levels of electrolytes, and that will make you feel horrible. So you have to keep your electrolyte levels neutral or a little on the higher side. Now, what are the causes when it comes to this? Well, ketogenic diet is basically your diet. That's the cause. So if you're keeping your carbs really low, your proteins moderate, and your fats high, especially if you then incorporate intermittent fasting, which we recommend a lot with our patients in the office and also to our subscribers and whoever's in our keto course, you know we recommend intermittent fasting in about the second or third phase of the program as we start to incorporate that. Well, in this case, it's not caused by diet as much as it's caused by type 1 diabetes, which can be diet related because you don't really have much of any insulin at all, but yet you're maybe eating cakes and pies and pastries, so it could be caused by diet. But it's type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, and it's also caused by illness and infection. Now, what are the health benefits, if any? Well, of course, we know the health benefits of the ketogenic diet. In ketosis, they're numerous. I did a video just recently where I talked about the many, many benefits of the ketogenic diet and why I believe it's the best diet, or I should say lifestyle, out there. So weight loss. First, it was developed to help patients with epilepsy. You're looking at things like disease prevention, like heart disease, cancer, diabetes. I talked about the fact that cancer loves sugar, so when you reduce sugars, like in a ketogenic diet, and increase your healthy fats, that prevents cancer. Why? Because cancer cells only can metabolize sugars. They cannot metabolize fats. You want to eliminate heart disease, diabetes. Alzheimer's improves on the ketogenic diet. Mental clarity and greater energy. It's a fact. Your brain runs really well off of ketones. And when it does, there's very, very high mental clarity, high mental acuity. You don't have to worry about the brain fog you typically do and the crashes that you get when you're on a glucose diet, where you're eating glucose and you need a muffin and coffee and a muffin and coffee and more bread and more coffee and things like that. It just gets out of control. You don't have to worry about that when you're using fats for fuel over here. Greater energy. Once again, you're burning fats. Fats are like burning logs. It's a long, sustained, nice energy. Whereas, once again, blood sugar, it's up and down and up and down. You know it because you feel it. You get those, you know, pangs where all of a sudden you feel like you need something, you need that fix, you get some bread, you get a muffin, you get something, and you're good for a little while, and then you start to crash again. So you know it's true. Any health benefits to ketoacidosis? No, definitely not. In fact, it's very, very detrimental. Now, symptoms. Well, some great symptoms when it comes to the keto diet. Weight loss, better mental clarity once again, energy, increased, you know, performance, all kinds of great symptoms when it comes with that. Symptoms of ketoacidosis, this is what you have to watch out for. Exhaustion, fatigue, mental confusion, nausea, vomiting. If you're experiencing things like that, that is becoming a medical emergency. Now, it's very different than what we call keto flu. Keto flu is different because these are things that your body's experiencing as it's detoxing. Yeah, you might have some mental confusion, but it's simply because your body's used to burning sugar for fuel, and now it's having to turn fat, so you don't have that sugar up in your brain like you typically do. You might have a little bit of loss of energy at first because your body has to flip that switch to where it's burning fat for fuel. So there are some symptoms early on when you first start the ketogenic diet, but they go away quickly. They go away within a week. So once again, there's things you can do to get rid of keto flu, which is one, maybe start taking more electrolytes. Dangers, none. No dangers of the ketogenic diet. The ketogenic diet is, or ketogenic lifestyle, I should say, it's all healthful, all good things from, once again, this is our genetic blueprint. This is the way our ancestors have been eating for tens, if not hundreds of thousands of years. What about ketoacidosis? That's a medical emergency, okay? You can face coma, you can face death. So you need to make sure that if you're type 1 diabetic, it's not to say that you can't do this. You can. You can do the keto diet, but you have to make sure you're doing it correctly, okay? Get in touch with my office or write me. Put some comments down below. We'll help guide you along, or once again, check out our keto course. That's a great way that we can literally hold your hand all the way through, so that way you're getting the best results possible and do it in the safest way possible, okay? So once again, if you're type 1 or type 2 diabetic, if you have some illness, you can still do the ketogenic diet or ketogenic lifestyle, and it will be very beneficial for you. You just have to know how you're doing it. Well, anyway, I hope this is great information for you. If so, please make sure you like, share, comment, and subscribe. But more importantly, watch the other videos we've got. If you like this video, you're going to love these other ones. And watch for future videos coming out. Make sure you click that little bell notification so you're notified anytime I come on with a video. Well, this is Dr. Nick. I love and appreciate you. I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.